Hey guys, it's Huff. I am back again. This is the first time filming videos in far too long. This is the top 18 in 18. I'm a little behind. This is a collab with a whole bunch of other Nayli people. We talk on Instagram and do collabs on YouTube and Instagram. So they'll all be linked down below. This was supposed to be up on the 31st, and it's about 7 o'clock, nearly 7 o'clock on the 31st when I'm filming this, so it's going to be a little late, but I'll get there. So this is the top 18 nail polishes of 2018 for me. This was actually really hard because I spent most of my year swatching old nail polish, and I bought some new nail polish, but it was all old new nail polish, so like new to me but old. And I'm sorry if you can hear noises in the background. It's the evening in my house and my house is noisy. Two of the, I've got like two categories, like two brands, and then all the rest are individual polishes, although several are from the same brand. So this is in no particular order whatsoever. So the first one I'm going to talk about is this one here. This is Ulta 3's It's a Bit Grey. I picked this up several times when I wanted a grey polish. Like, it was the one I went to for grey polishes. Which, I don't normally have, like, favourites with colours. I just... this one was the one this year that I went to quite a bit. It doesn't look that great on the first coat, but I'll do two coats and then you'll see. It's just a really good solid grey. So that's my first favourite for the year. The next few are all from the same brand. Two of them are from the same collection, but I love them both and I didn't just want to do the brand itself. So the first one is another grey. This is Essence. I think this was in my favourites last year, but it's still a favourite. This is from the Icy Matte Winter Glow collection. This one is Icy Ice. It dries matte, but you can top coat it and make it like super duper shiny if you really want to. It's a really interesting one. And the other one that is from the same collection is the red one. I want all of these, but they're almost impossible to get now. This one is Miss Frost. This is one of my favourite reds this year. I think I got it towards the end of last year, like 2017. But the second coat makes it look even better. These are all like pretty good formulas too, which helps when you're like talking about that. The other one from Essence is, it's really this like line, the Glow and Care line. I got, I think like four of them or something on clearance. This one I actually was one of my ones for the Nail Polish Hounds, Pantone colour thing. This is literally a one coat polish. Sorry, I had a lump in it. This is a one coat polish and it is so beautiful. And the other ones from this line that I have are all really pretty too. I mean, they're very pretty colours, but they're slightly muted and they're just gorgeous. They really are. I'm sorry if the light's a bit funky. I can't really tell because of the angle that my camera lens is at. And the last one is the Hollow Rainbow collection that Essence did, which in Australia we only got four, and I think there were five of them, but for some reason we only got four. And then there was another collection that I just got the other day. I think it's the Cosmic collection, and I think there are four in that one or five in that one, and we only got like three. So I don't know what it is with Australia and them not giving us all of them. But all of the ones that I got from this collection, I absolutely love. Because they're a drugstore brand, and yet they're pulling out hollow like this. Like, that is awesome. Absolutely awesome. Another drugstore brand, I guess you could call that, is Model Zone. This is actually the only one of these. Actually, I've got another one. I think I got a blue one as well. This is their chrome line. I love chrome nail polishes. A lot of people complain because they chip really easily, but I don't wear my nail polish long enough for that to be an issue. So this one is chrome mauve. I think the blue one I have is chrome indigo. You've got to remember to shake these really well, which I didn't really do, so it looks kind of silver. So I have to make sure I shake it properly before the next coat. But I really love chrome polishes. So speaking of chromes, one of my other favourites, and they have been a perennial favourite for me for probably 8 or 9 years, and that is the Sally Hansen Chrome Nail Makeup. This is not the new line, this is the really old one. This is the best chrome nail polish out there, and it's... I have several of these. I think I have like 6 or 7 bottles in different colours, and they are just fantastic. So they made my favourites again, which shouldn't be a surprise to anybody who knows me. And lastly, on the chrome line, I told you it was a year of chrome for me this year. I managed to pick up the majority of this collection from China Glaze, which it's a pretty old collection, which is the crinkled chromes, which I know not everybody liked. I think a lot of people disliked them because they got bar glitters in them. But I love these because I love textured polish. So if you're not into textured polish, this one is not going to be for you. This one happens to be due to be foiled, but I have a whole bunch from this line and I love them. They are basically a one coat nail polish. You have to put them on, you know, relatively thick, like you can't do like a super thin coat. And you really don't want to have to go back in for a second coat because it just makes a mess of things. But if you put it on a decent coat, you don't need the second one. So that's that one. So the other one, which is another line that I picked up quite a lot of this year, is the holographic, old holographics from China Glaze. Not the new stuff, this is the old one. I have almost the whole of this line as well. Gradually picked it up over the majority of the last 2 years, bit by bit. This one is all OMG, a UFO. These are not the most hollow of hollows, but they are a decent, in my opinion, holographic polish. I'm working in a really awkward space, so this probably looks super awkward. They don't look holographic when they're wet. It's when they dry that they look really good. Another brand that's sort of similar to that, but completely different. What I mean is the brands are similar. So this one's OPI. Again, this is more the line than an individual polish. This is the Liquid Sands line. I managed to pick up a whole bunch of these this year. Again, I like textured polishes. If you don't like textured polish, you're probably not going to like these. And some of them are sparkly and some of them are not. One of my favourites, which I don't actually... it's in another container at the moment, is... It's all San Andreas's fault, which is not shiny. It doesn't have any glitter in it at all. It's just a textured brown polish, and it looks like chocolate cake. I'm actually going to do a chocolate cake manicure with it because it reminds me so much of cake. It has that look to it. This one is Solitaire, which is a white texture polish, which you don't get very often. It's not one that they generally go for. There's one from this line which is called Jinx, which is pinky red, and it is absolutely gorgeous. And that is that one. Another favourite from a sort of fairly regular line, if you notice I haven't done any indies yet, there's actually only two indies in this, unlike a lot of other people. I did buy a few indies this year, but not a huge amount. I spent most of the time this year, like the year before I bought lots of indies, but like this year I really focus more on older lines of more mainstream brands. It's just the year I had. So this one is a Revlon one from their old metallic line. This one is called Silver Dollar. I used this a few times and it became one of my favourite silvers ever. Silver is a colour that I'm a little funny about, and it has to be good, and it has to be the right kind of silver. It's a bit like gold, some golds don't look that great. But this quickly became one of my favourite silvers to use this year. Way back in February, I did a purple palooza, and so that was 28 days of different purple polishes, and I could have picked lots from that because a lot of them were really cute. But when I looked back on my Instagram, this is the one that jumped out at me. This is a Layla ceramic effect. They're really hard to get hold of, but if you can get hold of these, you should, because the Layla brand, anything from Layla pretty much, was like really, really good. But this was my favorite pretty much from February. Whoops, that was a really bad paint job. Now, it doesn't look like much on the first coat, but after the second one, it's fabulous. Fabulous. Another one of my favorites is this polish here. It says it from Gade or Jade. I don't know how they like to say it. Or Garde. I don't know. I have a couple of their Crystal Glow nail polishes. I have this one and then I have a blue one as well. This one looks like beetle wings. And I love that look. And it doesn't need a black base, which a lot of polishes like this do need. It does need two coats, it just doesn't need a black base. So that's that one. The first of two indies. This is more like the brand. Angel Kiss is an Aussie indie. Well, it was an Aussie indie. She stopped making polish. But I wore this at one stage this year and I just couldn't stop looking at my nails. It's such a beautiful teal colour. This is Teal We Meet Again. If you know me, you know I like teal. Ironically, there's not a lot of purple in this collection of polishes, but this is such a beautiful teal colour. So beautiful. The other indie is probably no surprise to anybody. This is still in my favourites. This is Glam Polishes The Dance of Dragons, which is basically me in a bottle. I love this polish. I was going to wear it for my wedding, but instead I used Essence Nail Powders, which again are another one of my favourites from this year. I used them on gel, even though you can use them on normal polish. They work better on gel, quite frankly. So if you're looking for chrome powders to use on gel polish, the Essence ones are great. And I highly recommend them, especially as they are considerably cheaper than most of the other brands of nail chrome powders that you can actually get. So, a very recent purchase, which has been on my nails multiple times since I bought it. I haven't actually done a swatch video for these ones yet that I bought recently. This is one of the Colour Therapy ones. I got several of these at a very discounted price. This one is Smoky Emerald, and I think you probably can work out why I like it. It doesn't make me think of emeralds at all, but it is super beautiful. So it's got a fairly dark base. It's actually quite similar base colour to Dance of Dragons, but it's got this green, like tealy green sparkle in it, but at certain angles of the nail it is actually purple, which is, me again. So this is kind of like me in a bottle too. So the last two little groupies that I'm going to look at are two brands that surprised me in a good way. So the first one is actually Born Pretty. I get review mail from them on a fairly regular basis. And these two here are actually stamping polishes. So this is a holographic stamping polish which stamps beautifully, but they also look great just as a nail polish. And considering the price of these, I know these are quite small bottles, but they're only 6ml bottles. But even still, for the price, these are actually magnificent. If you live in the US, they do have the US warehouse, so you don't have to wait for it to come from China anymore. And because I live closer to China, it still takes time, but it's not as bad as it, you know, could be. So I like both of these. This one is called Moonlit. This is just their hollow, silver hollow stamper. If you know me, you know I love a silver hollow. And I always tend to gravitate towards them. So every time I get an opportunity to buy a silver hollow, I tend to. The only problem with these particular Born Pretty bottles, and I think they've changed them since, is that the handle is really, really short. But these are really quite magnificent. And because they're meant as a stamping polish, they do cover quite nicely. Yes, you still need to probably put two coats on, but whatever. I usually put two coats on anyway. The hollow in the silver one is amazing. And the last one is another brand, which is a new to me brand that I got from my supply company that I get my acrylics through, and it's called Fabi. I'm not exactly sure how they pronounce it. It's a really low cost, like this size bottle, because these are from a mini set. This size bottle is $5, or under $5. Now, this particular colour looks very much like Green on the Runway from OPI. I will probably do a comparison later on between the two of them, because it does look very similar in the bottle to it. This one is called Cleo's Talisman. I haven't actually swatched or worn this one, so I don't know what it looks like. But I was actually really impressed with the quality of these polishes. They were like really good for the price. I think they're actually quite amazing. So I thought, you know, well, seeing as how I haven't swatched this one yet, we'll swatch this one together. Because I bought a whole bunch of them the last time I did a big order from my supply company. And I thought I would try them out. Because I tried out the little ones, but I hadn't tried out the big bottles. So I'm just going to put a coat of this other one on, so that I can do the last one, which is another Fabi one. I mean, as you can see, that's just one coat. It's actually really, really good. It's almost a one coat polish. That one is Tapis de Fleur. It's a beautiful colour. So I was like super impressed with that brand, and I noticed when I was buying some extra bottles to try out other colours, they had a silver holographic topper. So I had to buy it, didn't I? So yeah, so what I'm going to do is I am going to put another coat on the ones that need another coat, and then I will be back. Here we have it. These are my... zoom out the little volume. These are the top 18 of 2018 for me this year. So we have It's a Bit Grey from Ultra 3. We have the two ones from Essence, Icy Ice and Miss Frost. I've actually put top coat on the bottom half so you can see how it changes how it looks. This is Love and Care from the Essence Glow and Care line. This is the Holo one, which I didn't tell you, but yes, called Hello Holo. That's two coats of Hello Holo, and it is full coverage. The Chrome Mauve from Model Zone. The Garnet Chrome from Sally Hansen, perennial favourite. OMG, don't be foiled. Sorry, I was like, wrong one. From the Crinkled Chrome line from China Glaze. OMG, a UFO. I don't know how well my camera is picking up the holo on that. It is a linear holo that just shows up when it's dry. It doesn't show up when it's wet. Solitaire from the Liquid Sands line from OPI, which is, like, I like the whole of that line. Silver Dollar from Revlon. The Layla Ceramic Effect, it's number 64, in case you're wondering. It's got kind of like a really nice blue, purpley blue shift to it. I hope that was showing up. Blue Satin from Agade. I hope the beetle wingy effect is showing. It's a bit hard to tell. Till We Meet Again from Angel Kiss Nail Lacquer. Dance of Dragons from Glam Polish. Again, I don't know if my camera is showing it up. Smoky Emerald from Sally Hansen's Color Therapy line. I again don't know how well that's showing up. These two here are the Born Pretty stamping polishes. The what's it called again? Moonlit and the Holo. You can see how strong that holographic is. Absolutely beautiful. And that shows up when you stamp even something quite fine. It shows up. So that one there is the Fabi Cleo's Talisman, which is a really interesting colour. And then on top of the Tapestry Fleur, I have the holographic topper, which is called the Magic Wand. Yeah, so they are my favourites, and some of them are just favourite brands or favourite lines of 2018. Thanks so much for watching. If you want to subscribe, click the button down below. Don't forget to go and check everybody else out and give them some love. And if you're coming from someone else's channel, hello, welcome. Leave me a thumbs up if you like best of videos, and leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to every comment when I'm doing well. Normally I do read every comment, I just sometimes forget to comment back. So, I will see you guys in my next video. See ya!